أفنت حبين أكواشن في إمام مالك. وحكى ابن العربي عن الزبير بن بكار قال سمعت مالك بن أنس وأتاه رجل أما أن قمت إمام مالك ask him question. And these students, they knew the value of the question. Someone asking, you bring your paper and pen and listen to the question and listen to the answer of the sheikh, and that will be a lesson for you. What the man wants. فقال يا عبد الله من أين أحرم؟ I want to go to Umrah. From where I should start my ihram? Where is Imam Malik? Masjid Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Masjid Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Yes. So he asked him, from where I should start my ihram? He said, min idhil hulayfa. Go all the way to the hulayfa and start from there. Why? من حيث أحرم رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. Because the Prophet ﷺ started his ihram from that point. So you walk from Masjid Medina all the way to Dhul Hulayfa, and from Dhul Hulayfa you start your ihram. Man wants rewards. Wants to earn some extra rewards. So he said, فإني أريد أن أحرم من المسجد. I want to do إحرام from the masjid of Medina. He didn't say extra rewards. What he said, say, لا تفعل, don't do it. Don't do it. Why? فإني أخشى عليك الفتنة. I fear, yeah, you fall on fitna, yeah, tribulation, fitna. A world we can fall in the fitna. Avoid the fitna. The man asked him, why are you fitna in Hadi? Yeah. What fitna it can happen to me? Innaha amyalu azidwa. Extra steps. I'm walking while I'm in the ihram. Extra steps, I'm walking while I am in the ihram. This is Mecca, and that is Medina. And these touches are the boundary of the miqat of Mecca. If you want to Hajj and Umrah, you can't enter that zone without ihram and intention. Dhul Hulayfa, it's close to Medina. So Prophet ﷺ, he walked from Medina all the way to Dhul Hulayfa. And he started his miqat, his ihram from there. And this man wants to start from Medina. This is the map, Masjid al-Nabawi. And this is Dhul Hulayfa, the direction of Mecca. So this is roughly 11 kilometers, 8 miles. So Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam walked from here to Dhul Hulayfa. He prayed Salat al-Dhuhr at Masjid al-Nabawi, 4 rak'ah. And then he came to Dhul Hulayfa, prayed Salat al-Asr, 2 rak'ah. From there, he started his ihram, the Prophet. So this man wanted to start from Masjid al-Nabawi and get all that steps as extra rewards. Imam Malik said, that's fitna. You are facing fitna. So man asked him, what fitna are you expecting to happen? In my here, I'm yelling, just a few steps as you to her. Look at your understanding of the scholars. Qala, why you fitnatin a'adamu? He say, any tribulation is greater than أنك ترى, you think أنك سبقت إلى فضيلة, you got some extra rewards قصر عنها رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, which Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم didn't know and didn't practice. That is the fitna. And then he gave him evidence. إِنِّي سَمِعْتُ اللَّهَ يَقُولُ I heard Allah saying. فَلْيَحْذَرِ الَّذِينَ يُخَالِفُونَ عَنْ أَمْرِهِ Those who oppose the commands of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, be aware of and to see بهم فتنة to fall, to befall on the fitna, tribulation in this life, or you see بهم عذاب أليم, or you get painful torment on the judgment day. One of two or both. Either one of two or both. When we oppose the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. See وهم فتنة, we see وهم عذاب أليم. The understanding of the Imam Malik. That's why he's Imam. That's why he's Imam. So in conclusion, we should not celebrate anything in our life or in the life of our children other than Eid al-Adha and Eid al-Fitr. Nothing else. Otherwise, you are falling in the fitna. And you are pushing the paradise away and away from you when you practice. The question, the food of a celebration, Maulid al-Nabi, is it halal or haram? It's haram. It's haram. If someone gives you something today, which he didn't give you yesterday, or last month, or month before, the occasion of this period is coming under. For example, Christmas. If someone invites you in October, and invites you in November, and invites you in December, that's okay. But he doesn't invite you all the year. At the month of December, he invites you. That's haram. That's part of the Christmas. That's part of the Christmas. So the food they do it at the time of Maulid al-Nabi, in the month of Rabi' al-Awwal, is haram to eat. Haram to eat. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم واستغفروه إنه الغفور الرحيم وصلى الله وسلم على النبي وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين.